PICO, presenting interactive content presentations, bring together the advantages of both orals and posters and open up the opportunity for strengthened interaction between speakers and listeners. Introduced at the 2013 EGU General Assembly, PICOs are now a growing medium to communicate scientific research. Each PICO session starts with a series of two-minute-long presentations where each author describes the essence of their work, aiming to get the audience to want to find out more. After this two-minute madness, the audience can then learn more on interactive touchscreens, where authors are also available to answer questions and discuss their research in more detail. Here is an example of a two-minute talk by Dr. Kurt Konhauser to grab the audience's attention.
Anyways, as Noah pointed out, there's quite a bit of information about oxygenation through time, and as Noah mentioned, there is the standard two-stage evolution of atmospheric oxygen, with the first one being what we call the great oxidation event. Now, the one thing that, if you read the literature, that becomes very apparent is it seems that we don't actually know very much about how oxygen first arose and then basically accumulated through time. Now, where I will disagree with a lot of people is I think we know quite a bit about oxygenation, and in particular, the great oxidation event itself. Because when you take a look at the rock record, there is a lot of information in there that tells us something about when oxygen arose. For example, very briefly, all the lines in the red are telling us that after or right before 2.4, there's clear evidence that there's oxygen available to give us these signatures in the rock record. The green arrows are telling us all the evidence in the rock record which are saying that oxygen simply wasn't there. So in other words, it seems, for at least from my perspective, that the great oxidation event, although it's a transient event, somewhere between 2.45 and 2.3, is, I think, firmly established. So, what do we then do with these recent papers that have come out? One of them being the paper that Noah talked about, Sean Crow, and the other paper being Noah's, which I'm a co-author on. The question being is, if the great oxidation event, which records when there was oxygen in the atmosphere, is firmly established, at least in my mind, at 2.45, how then do we reconcile these papers that suggest that there could have been oxygen already around 3 billion years ago? And I think the answer is pretty straightforward, is that you can have oxidative weathering, but it has nothing to do with the atmosphere. What that is that the oxidation step itself took place on a very small scale. Think in terms of biological soil crust, think in terms of microbial mats. At that interface, within a mat, within just 100 microns in thickness, you can get enough oxygen generated that you can produce the oxidative weathering features one sees in a rock record, despite the fact that the atmosphere itself is still anoxic. In other words, we can have the cake and eat it too by having oxygen being produced at 3 billion years, but this has nothing to do with the atmosphere itself. And if you want some more information, just come to my presentation. Thank you.